Hi, welcome to What's on Your Plate, where we'll discuss food and nutrition for rider students. I'm Caroline Downing. This week, we'll talk about how to improve a peanut butter and jelly sandwich with Chow Time with Caroline. We'll also be checking in with one of our fellow rider students to see if he can lose 20 pounds in 10 weeks. We'll also be checking out some of the local Lawrenceville flavor. First, let's see what some rider students would do to switch up their peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
All right, it's going to be bread with peanut butter on it.
A chunky peanut butter on it, lots of it, and very little jelly because I personally don't like jelly.
Put bread on top of that. Put some jelly on that bread.
I would like chunky peanut butter for my peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
Put bread on top of that. Put peanut butter fluff on that one, and not the bread.
I think the best kind of peanut butter and jelly sandwich is with toasted bread because the peanut butter spreads better.
If you want to, go crazy and toast it.
It's definitely not whole wheat bread because whole wheat sucks.
A peanut butter sandwich with wheat bread. That's the ultimate peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Well, those were some pretty creative ideas, but I've got one of my own. Check it out. One of Elvis Presley's favorite foods was a peanut butter and banana sandwich. For this recipe, you'll need a banana, 2 teaspoons of butter, 2 slices of bread, and peanut butter. First step in this recipe, smash the banana in a bowl. Bananas are actually a great food to eat while you're at college. Apparently, if you eat a banana a day, you won't get mosquito bites, and it's really good for leg cramps because of the potassium. You can use a fork, we're using a wooden spoon. It doesn't matter how much banana you put on the sandwich, it's up to you. Mash it until it's a spreadable consistency. Another alternative, if you don't have time to mash it, is to slice it up into little slivers and put it on top of the peanut butter. There, so once it looks like this, it's about ready to spread on the sandwich. Next step is peanut butter. Again, you only need to use as much as you want. You can use either chunky or smooth peanut butter. I'm pretty sure Elvis's preferred texture was the smooth. Once your peanut butter is evenly spread, you can add the banana paste. Even if it's not perfectly smooth, it's okay. Your next step would be to butter both sides of the sandwich so it's ready to grill. You probably won't be using as much butter as Elvis did. He was known to eat 12 of these at a time. Wouldn't recommend that either. Now your sandwich is ready for the stove. Okay. Make sure to have it on low heat so it doesn't burn. Leave it about 2 minutes on one side and then check to make sure it's golden brown and then flip it. I think our sandwich is just about done. Perfect. It's really good and it's a great source of protein. See you next week, Chow Time with Caroline. Getting fit can be a real challenge, especially when living on a college campus. One of our very own rider students is about to find out what it takes to turn his life around. Here's 20 and 10 with Tom.
This is my friend Tom. Him and I have been friends for 2.5 years now. He's a pretty good guy. But the thing about him is, he loves to eat. I've been trying to get him to lose weight for a while now, and I think he's finally ready to give it a shot. Him and I have decided to make a video diary to aid the process. 20 pounds in 10 weeks is our goal, and I'm gonna do what I can to help him through it. My name's Dan, and this is 20 and 10 with Tom.
So yeah, this is basically what I do. I mean, when I'm not working over at the TV studio or working with the Giants, I pretty much just come here to try and relax. You know, sometimes I don't always have the time to do that, but when I do, I take advantage of it. So this is basically my average meal. You know, I try to eat healthy, I do what I can, but sometimes it's not always so easy, and I end up giving in to some temptations. I want to lose weight because I just feel like I have no energy at all, ever. I'm always tired, I always feel fatigued. I mean, just doing simple things like just going out and walking for a prolonged period of time and then talking to somebody, I feel like I'm winded, I'm out of breath. And I also know that in my family's got a history of diabetes. And my grandfather was debilitated by it. My father had a scare for a little while where he supposedly had diabetes, where he was on the verge of it. And I just feel like I'm starting to go down that same road. I feel like if I maintain the weight that I'm at right now, or God forbid I gain any more weight, it's just gonna end up getting worse.
Six AM, day after Christmas, I throw some clothes on in the dark. The smell of cold, car seat is freezing, the world is sleeping, I am
alright, so now that you're here, I know you haven't probably exercised in a while, so I figured we'd start with the old gym class mile run.
Alright, dude, fair enough. Let's go.
Good
luck.
So here we are, we're at about 8 minutes. He's about 3/4 of the way done. He was pretty heavily winded at about 1/2 mile, but you know, he's pushing through it. And for the first time not exercising, after a while, you know, for the first time getting out there, it can be really tough. And I think Tom's doing a really good job right now, and you know, we'll finish the mile, which is a step in the right direction.
I feel like I just got the crap kicked out of me.
Feels good though, right?
Right now? No. Right now it feels awful.
Well, you did it.
Yeah. And now I gotta do that for 10 weeks, huh?
A couple times a week. So Tom just finished his mile. It took him about 11 minutes. At 5.5 speed. He's pretty winded. Feels like which is totally understandable, but I think the most important thing is that he actually finished it and was motivated to finish it, because I asked him to stop if he wanted to stop at about 1/2 mile, and he said he was good. So, you know, that's progress. We'll see what happens next week.
Keep up the great work, Tom. I'm sure you'll lose that weight in no time. Ryder's surrounded by some pretty great local restaurants. Let's check out what Nicole and Jess found about one of them.
Each week, I will be highlighting one food establishment that is near campus. These places will all be delicious, inexpensive, and convenient. This week, let's check out a quaint pizzeria that many of you may not be familiar with. King's Pizzarama, better known as King's Pizza, is a small Italian restaurant that you could easily miss. From the minute you walk in the door, you are greeted with a friendly smile and an overwhelming food selection, some of which are pizza, subs, chicken, and other Italian favorites. The pizza is made right in front of your face. You can order the classic cheese pizza, dress it up with toppings, or get a Sicilian. And if you're on a budget, they have plenty of specials and even give students a discount, as written on the menu. There's so many choices, it may be hard just to choose one. But the most popular is the Buffalo Chicken Pizza. So if you like spicy, this is the one for you. This place may be small, but the classic food and the comfortable atmosphere more than make up for it. Now, if you're trying to figure out what makes this place different than other pizza places, well, it would have to be the friendly service. If you're not sure what to order, they will gladly offer suggestions. So if you're looking for a delicious pizza at an affordable cost, then Kings might just be the place for you. Kings Pizza is located in Ewing and only 5 minutes away. But if you don't feel like driving, you can always call at 609-882-3042 and get it delivered. And this has been Restaurant of the Week with Jess and Nicole.
You can place your order today on campusfood.com. Thanks for joining us here on What's on Your Plate. Happy eating!